This episode of Star Trek, The Omega Glory, had a history of rejection. It was originally written by Gene Roddenberry early on in the history of the show. NBC produced the pilot, The Cage, and made an unprecedented request for a second pilot. The Omega Glory, Mudd's Women, and Where No Man Has Gone Before were all considered as a second pilot. Omega was shelved, and Where No Man went into production with Mudd's Women following soon after. It wasn't until the second season that Omega was dusted off and rewritten and rejected again. Twice more, in fact, once by the NBC execs and once by Star Trek's co-producer, Bob Justman. But there was no keeping a mediocre script down. It does have some fascinating political analogies for its time and some excellent action sequences. So here is The Omega Glory. One can observe a little continuity problem in this episode. Omega's rulers, the Combs, declare themselves to be 1,000 years old, even though intergalactic travel has only been around for 200 years. Also, there's a funny play on words within the Omega Glory. The Combs were considered the communists. The Yangs were the Yankees. When this episode originally aired, it was followed by the on-air announcement that Star Trek had been renewed for a third season, which pleased not only the series fans, but the cast and crew as well. The Omega Glory. What's in a title? The dictionary tells us that Omega means the last, the final. Perhaps what we're watching was meant to be a cautionary tale about the ravages of war. Remember that while Star Trek was being produced, we were fighting in Vietnam and that many Americans felt it was a war we should not be involved in. Perhaps we periodically need to be reminded of the principles by which our country was founded. Much as the Yangs need to take a closer look at the meanings of their symbols. If we're to understand where we're going, we must not lose sight of where we've been.